Hi everyone, I'm Paige and this is a day in my life as a second year natural sciences student at the University of Cambridge. It was an early start since I was coxing a rowing outing that morning. First thing on the agenda was to have something quick to eat just to give me a bit of a boost. I don't usually have time for a full breakfast, so I went for a Belvita soft bake. I had a quick drink of water and then made my bed in an attempt to make my room tidy. As you can see, I am always full of energy in the mornings. Believe it or not, I had gone to bed early the night before to ensure I wasn't sleep deprived. I've been there, done that last year, and the caffeine dependent life is not an experience I want to repeat. I managed to drag myself to the bathroom, brushed my teeth, washed my face, and gradually started to wake up a bit more. And here I am straightening my hair as I do most days of the week. Some may find it weird that I bother to do this at this time of the morning, but I suppose it shows you where my priorities lie. I checked the weather forecast, only to find the temperatures had really dropped. -1 degrees Celsius. That is not ideal when you're supposed to be spending a couple of hours sitting still in a boat. So here I am putting on multiple layers of clothing, including many thermal and fleecy layers, to prepare for my very chilly coxing experience. Check me out, getting up at this ungodly hour and preparing to go out in the freezing cold weather. If this isn't commitment to the boat club, then I don't know what is. Coxing and my involvement with the college boat club is something I'm doing outside of my studies this year, and it's a great break from work, even if it does mean I have to be a morning person. I made sure my bag was packed with everything I needed for the day and headed off to the boathouse. I crept down the stairs, trying not to wake up any other staircase residents. The boathouse is about a 5-minute cycle from college. I got my bike lights out and put on my bike helmet because safety, of course, and cycled to the boathouse. It was a quiet ride, not much traffic on the roads, because I suppose no one else in their right mind is up at this time of morning. I arrived at the boathouse at about 6:10 and headed up to the changing room to dump my stuff. I put my woolly hat on to stay warm. It's in the Jesus College colours, red and black. As I am coxing one of the senior college crews this year, our outings are slightly earlier in the mornings before the river gets busy with all the novices. We got the boat out on the water while it was still dark. Here I'm just hanging around on the boathouse balcony while the rowers all warm up. As a cox, I have to wear a life jacket and I also use a cox box so my voice is amplified over the boat. It would have been a bit of a hazard for me to film while coxing, but here's some footage of the river once the sun had risen. My outing was about 2 hours, so I cycled back to college at 8:10. I use my bike to get myself around every day whilst I'm at uni. I really don't know what I'd do without it. Lectures don't start till 9, so I had time to stop off back at college and lock up my bike. I was very pleased to make it back to my room because it was so cold outside. You have no idea how cold it was. Well, I mean, you do because I showed you the weather forecast, but trust me, it was freezing. Here I am warming my hands on the radiator. So I took my shoes off and then I went off to get changed out of my splash jacket and thermals and into some more appropriate clothing for lectures. At this point, I drew my curtains to let some light in. I have massive windows in my room this year. It's always pleasant when it's a sunny morning. Shortly after, it was time to cycle to my first lecture of the day. I put my winter coat on because it was so cold and grabbed my bike helmet. Please don't judge the state of my bike. It's an old hire bike, but it does the job, even if it's a bit squeaky at times. I made it to the site of my lecture a whole 10 minutes early, which was very impressive for me. I was one of the first ones into the lecture theatre. As you can see, it's quite empty at this point. It did mean that I could bag see my favourite seat closest to the projector screen so I could see everything. My friends eventually arrived as well, but here they are being mean and not talking to me. Look, I'm being bullied. I'm just kidding, they eventually paid attention to the camera, played up to it a bit, you know. So I'm taking 3 modules this year, Physics A, Physics B and Maths. So this first lecture was on Physics B. We're currently doing electromagnetism. I'd say I'm finding it the most challenging of my 3 modules at the moment. It's quite fast paced and imagining it all geometrically is quite tricky. I like to highlight and annotate my lecture notes to keep me focused in lectures. The lecture lasted 1 hour and then I had a 1 hour break before my next lecture started, so I headed off to the library. Each week I get set a set of problems by my supervisors for each module. These questions are based on the stuff we've studied in lectures and then we hand them into our supervisors for them to be marked each week. We then discuss these questions in supervisions, which are small group teaching sessions with our supervisor. Here I am getting on with some questions for my Physics B module, which I had just had the lecture on because I was in the zone for that module. The stuff in the lecture was fresh in my mind, so I thought, why not get going on the questions? At just before 11, I walked to the lecture theatre where my next lecture was being held. It's good to get to this lecture early and get a seat because this lecture theatre is quite small and people have been known to sit on the stairs before and not get a seat. This lecture was for my maths module. We are just moving on to matrices and linear algebra. I tend to write down more in my maths lectures because my lecturer leaves gaps in the lecture handouts. He then tells us what to fill in the gaps in the lecture, but it's a way of making people turn up to lectures because otherwise you'll have half complete lecture notes. After my maths lecture, I headed to my third lecture of the day, which was for my Physics A module. We're currently covering oscillations and waves. I'm usually quite tired by this point, and I have to make sure I push to stay concentrated for one more hour. Finally, lectures were finished for the day, and I headed back to my bike and cycled back to college. When I got back to my room, I got out some leggings, since I like to be comfortable while I'm studying, and also put on some fluffy slippers. I always make lunch for myself in my staircase kitchen, usually just a toasty because that's the extent of my culinary skills. I am very pleased with my new toasty machine though, £8 from Wilko, what a bargain, and boy does it take a regular sandwich to the next level. So here's the completed lunch, mini cheddars, a toasty and some fruit on my little coffee table in my room. I took a break and watched some YouTube whilst eating my lunch. And here I am getting my 5 a day, putting this in purely to show my parents that I'm staying healthy. And then I got back down to work. I carried on with the electromagnetism questions that I'd been doing earlier between lectures. I'm actually going over some of the previous week's work here as well and just making sure I fully understand everything I got wrong in the questions from the week before. Last year, I had a tendency to brush over things that I didn't understand and that just wasn't helpful. Then I got some coffee at about 3:30. While I drank my coffee, I carried on going through lecture notes and made flashcards where I needed to. I've been making more flashcards than ever this year and they're going to be really good to go over in the Christmas holiday. I find it easiest to make flashcards as I go along throughout term. I don't tend to make them in bulk. It's usually 2 or 3 at a time every now and again when I see something I need to remember. Just before 4, I left my room again with my bike helmet and cycled off to West Cambridge. Tim and I had a supervision at the West Cambridge site for our Physics B module. This is the physics building where our supervisions are held, which we still manage to get lost in every time. Our supervision overran, so we weren't out until 5:45, at which point we had to cycle back to college in the dark. It was a speedy bike ride back because I had plans for the evening. I got to putting on some makeup and transforming myself since I was going to formal that evening with my friends from the boat club. Formal is a 3-course meal held in the college hall, and it's a bit fancier than the normal college cafeteria. I go every so often for special occasions and just to have a nice time socialising with friends, and here I am dressed up and in my gown ready to head off. The empty tables here are the high tables where the fellows sit, and here are the rest of us. It's basically all of the boat club. We completely took over the formal that evening. And here are the custom napkins with the Jesus College rooster. Starter was ham hock, main was confit duck leg with something that very much tasted like baked beans, and dessert was hazelnut mousse with roasted cinnamon apples. After formal, we headed to the college bar, and shortly after, I headed back to my room and got ready for bed. Sorry to be a bore, but I really value my sleep at the moment. As always, I checked my diary for what I'd got planned for the next day. Life is so hectic at uni that it's quite easy to forget about things, so I like to be sure that I know exactly what I'm doing. I had a quick drink of water from my bottle originally intended for the gym. For those wondering, I haven't actually made it to the gym this term. At this point, I went to bed. Thank you for watching. Please give the video a like if you enjoyed it. And do subscribe, hit the notification bell, and I'll see you soon with another video. Bye!